potential difference.
The potential difference between the points. The potential difference between the points A and B in the adjoining circuit diagram will be. We are finding potential difference between A and B points. Now I am assuming from this 2 volts battery some current I flowing. When it comes to here, it is splitting into here I1 and here I2. This I2 continuation. So these all are in the series. This I1 continuation. These all are in the series. Here I1 I2 are splitting. So this effective and again this effective parallel. By taking like that way you do. Otherwise you apply Kirchhoff law. So this is A and B and this you take as C and D. So here first I am finding I1 and I2. I am taking C, B, D, C one circuit. A, C, D, A, C another circuit. Similarly, this total thing also another way you take. C, B, D, A, C. So here three circuits created. By taking any two circuits, we are finding I1 and I2. After we are going to finding potential difference between A and B. If you want to find the potential difference in between A and B, from here to here only you take one circuit. In that way, we are finding potential difference. So first you find I1 and I2. Now I am taking circuit CBDCB. Now I am taking circuit CBDCB. Circuit CBDCB. So first I am applying Kirchhoff's second law. Formula. According to Kirchhoff's second law, sum of the EMFs equal to sum of the potential loss. Sum of the EMFs equals to sum of the potential drops. Sum of the EMFs equal to sum of the potential drops. That is Kirchhoff's second law. So for this I am taking one sign convention. What is that? I am taking clockwise is positive. Anti-clockwise is negative by sign convention. Otherwise reverse also you take. So here current is flowing like this I2. Here current is flowing like this I1. Again I1 I2 combining here I form. Now I am taking CBDCB. Circuit CBDCB. Now you apply. Sum of the EMFs equal to sum of the potential drop. In this circuit, only one cell. This current outgoing, if you connect this only, if you connect this only, this is your circuit. Here, 2 volts. This is 5 ohm and this is 5 ohm and this is 5 ohm. Here this is 2 volts. This is my CBDC circuit. If you, when you are taking the circuit, current outgoing from positive to negative like this. So like this means clockwise. Positive to negative only we are taking. When we are taking cell, current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal only. Remaining currents we don't know. So, this is the positive, this is the negative. So, in this way current flowing. So, that is positive. So, sum of the EMFs equals to positive. So, 2E equals to sum of the potential terms. Here also I2 current like this one flowing. Like this means what? Positive. So, 5 into I2 plus 5 into I2. 5 into I2 plus 5 into I2. These all are plus. Again plus 5 into I2. So, 2 equals to 15 I2. So I2 equals to 2 by 15. This is my first equation. According to Kirchhoff's second law. Again, I want to find I1. Further, I am taking CDAC circuit. Same Kirchhoff's second law, you apply for CDAC. CDAC circuit. For this, you apply. Apply now. Applying for CDAC. So this is C, this is D, and this is A. And this is 5 ohm. This also 5 ohm, this also 5 ohm. Here battery connected. This is 2 volts battery. Current outgoing positive to negative. So negative current. In this circuit, some of the EMF equal, some of the potential also. But from here, how much flowing? I1 current flowing. Some of the EMFs from the circuit positive to negative like this. When you are taking cell only from positive to negative, when you are taking resistance from the resistance, what is the direction of the current? That only you take. There is a process. So positive to negative like this one. Apply now. This is minus, so minus 2 equals to, from here also like this, minus 5i1, minus 5i1, again minus 5i1. So minus 2 equals to minus 15i1. So i1 equals to 2 by 15 amperes. This is my second equation. Now I had got I1 and also I2. Now I am going to my circuit. Where you want to find the potential difference? Up to that only you take the circuit. So ACB circuit I am taking. Now I am going to ACB circuit. I1 also 2 by 15 came. Similarly, I1 also 2 by 15 came. Now I1 equals 2 by 15 came and also I2 also we had got 2 by 15. So I1 2 by 15 and I2 also 2 by 15. Now, I am going to ACB circuit, ACB, circuit ACB, so A and C and B only you take. This is my A and this is my B. Here 5 ohms, here I1 flowing, here 5 ohms, here 5 ohms, but here I2 flowing. So this is my circuit. In this closed circuit, this is C point. In this closed circuit, no cell. So, no potential terms. No EMFs. So, in this closed circuit, again you apply Kirchhoff's second law. Some of the EMFs equal to some of the potential terms. Here there is no cell. So, EMF equals to 0. So, some of the EMFs equals to 0. That equal to some of the potential terms. So, potential terms equal to what? Ri. Ri means 5 into I1. Again 5 into I2, 5 into I2 like that. Now, you apply sine convention. Here current like is going. Like this means negative. So minus 5i1. Again. Here of like this way. Like this means positive. Plus 5i2. Again plus 5i2. This is potential drop. Again in between A and B, what is the potential difference? I am taking VA minus VB. VA minus VB is my potential difference in between A and B. Ri, Ri, Ri. Again, in between A and B, what is the potential difference? Va minus Vb. Sum of the EMFs equal to sum of the potential terms. Okay, now, substitute all values. So, 0 equals to implies 0 equals to minus 5 into what about I1? 2 by 15 plus 5 into what about I2? Again 2 by 15 plus 5 into again 2 by 15 plus VA minus VB. So these two cancel. So 0 equals to 5 1s are 5 3s. 2 by 3 plus VA minus VB. So this implies VA minus VB. That equals to 2 by 3 like this one. So minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3 was not existed. So plus 2 by 3. Plus 2 by 3 means for that I am taking minus sum. VB minus VA. That equals to minus 2 by 3. Minus cancel. So VB minus VA. That equals to 2 by 3 volts. So the potential difference between A and B points is 2 by 3 volts. Here B is the more potential, A is the low potential. That is 2 by 3 volts. High potential, low potential. Effective current in this way going. In the circuit. So the potential difference between A and B points or B and A points, that is 2 by 3 volts. So that is the process for applying Kirchhoff's second law in a network.